Yesterday, we saw horrifying footage emerging of mounted patrol people trying to corral Haitian immigrants trying to cross the Texas border to seek asylum. Now, Haiti was just ravaged by an earthquake, and their president's assassination has left the country in chaos. But the administration is still flying migrants back there. Is this beyond an immigration issue? Is this a full-blown human rights crisis? And if it is, why aren't we treating it like one?
You know, these images, they're so horrific. And I think we need to remind ourselves, these are human beings, they're not animals. They deserve our great compassion and empathy. People don't leave their homes unless they are desperate to do so. It's a powerful example, I think, as well, of why foreign assistance is so important.
Yeah.
If people have no hope where they are, they're gonna move.
Yeah.
Human history is full of that. So my question to the Biden administration is, why aren't you talking about Haiti?
Yeah.
Why aren't you doing anything to help Haiti?
Yeah.
Why weren't you prepared for this? This shouldn't be a surprise, as you mentioned, an earthquake,
mm-hmm.
a coup, a pandemic.
Yeah.
Of course people are leaving.
Yeah.
Why is it a shock that 15,000 people show up at the border?
Yeah.
We gotta help them where
yeah.
they are.
Yeah. Yeah.
And the administration should have been, I think, better prepared,
yeah.
and I wish they'd talk about it.
Yeah.
Well, I think the reason that we're not seeing more help, if I'm gonna be frank about it, is because they're Haitian. I think
is
the history.
Explain, please, to the
Well, we saw it, and you and I talked about mm-hmm. this, Whoopi. We saw it when it first came to the demonizing of Haitians when it came to the AIDS crisis.
That's right.
And then we saw it continuing. It really began with the raping and, pilfering of France by Haiti and the punishment of Haiti for becoming the first black free nation in our hemisphere. And I think that U.S. policy towards Haiti has always been corrupt. And it doesn't have to be that way, because we know that the United States can do it. There is a way to do it. There's just no will to do it, because the United States and the White House has promised to bring 95,000 Afghans here. Mm-hmm. And I'm not saying they shouldn't be brought here, because they should be, right?
Yeah.
That is the promise of this country. But if you can bring 95,000 Afghans here, then why are you sending 86 Haitians back on an airplane to a country that has been devastated?
Yeah.
So it's not about whether or not there's a way. It's not about that there's a pandemic. But this policy started with the Trump administration. It's called Title 42, and the Trump administration decided to ban refugees from coming. So when people say, well, get in.